Hi, Scorpio Moon sign people. Welcome to your December 2018 full moon reading. It's a Cancer full moon this December, and boy, is it one to really, really pay attention to. You know, we have been in the Cancer North Node since November 7th. And it has been a seismic shift. It truly, truly has. Our nodes tell us where the planet is evolving to collectively, the collective consciousness. You can tell what your North Node is by doing your birth chart at the links below to kind of see what your personal soul evolution is for your lifetime. Well, we go through these every 2.5 years planetarily. It's very interesting, especially since we work with the Western and the Vedic astrology here. The Western astrology is Cancer North Node, Capricorn South. So that means that we're going toward more maternal energy, releasing some of that governmental kind of control issues. And those nodes are where the Vedic astrology is coming out of in March. So the Vedic astrology is going to shift to Gemini North Node, Sagittarius South Node in March. It's very interesting. Over these 4 months, the planet shares these nodes together. And I've just been observing the transits. So I'm just really fascinated, particularly because this is ninth house energy for you, Cancer Moon sign people. And ninth house energy is the sage. It is your wisdom. It's how you gain wisdom, whether it's through travel, study, research, as is often associated with your sign. It is your house of wisdom in your chart. And so a Cancer full moon that is in the North Node is one that is of planetary import. You will feel this intuitively. If you haven't already since November, you will sense a great shift. And in the one sense, that's because your Western astrology is where Jupiter is right now. So your moon sign, your sensibilities are enhanced. But then the Vedic is in Libra for most of you. Your Vedic moon sign is in Libra, which is where Venus is at this particular time. It's just gone direct. And so looking at your relationships, looking at global relationships and feeling and sensing those is really something that you might be particularly sensitive to at this time. Of course, the Great Mother Speaks channel is specifically designed for individuals who are experiencing mama drama trauma. Mama drama is a common experience in the mother-child bond. It is ordinary and normal to have blow-ups and episodes between mother and child. However, mama drama trauma is a consistent and persistent condition in which the mother projects unhealed aspects of herself onto the child, causing emotional and/or physical trauma. In cases where she's unable, unwilling, or unavailable to heal her own MDT, loving detachment is required in order to live a happy, healthy, and whole life. Now, mama drama trauma is a cycle. And so that's why we know that when she is unable, unwilling, or unavailable, she may have transitioned at this particular time. She may be an addict. We don't know. But whatever makes her unable to stop the cycle, and now we have inherited it, we want to stop the cycle. And we do that by living in loving detachment. Loving detachment is accepting what is. It's accepting the mother we have, okay? It's letting go of the fantasy mother so that we can accept the one we have. It's also accepting our divinity identity as opposed to an identity of MDT. So that's what my coaching work is all about. If you go to mamadramatrauma.info, you can book a coaching session. If you'd like a personal reading, go to greatmotherspeaks.info, and I'll be happy to help you there. This general reading for Scorpio moon sign says that for this Cancer full moon, Scorpios, you're approaching it with a real keen understanding of the abuse and abandonment issues surrounding your MDT. So maybe there is some anticipation of festivities over the holidays that you are engaging in or that you have chosen to alienate yourself from. And of course, Great Mother speaks to those of us who are most alienated and estranged from her love due to our birth mother experience. Now, it's not about blame, shame, or guilt, and that's not what it's about with you either. Of course, the sole evolutionary lesson of Mama Drama Trauma is self-love and spiritual independence. And this is telling me, this acknowledgement card, is that you have a great sense of that at this particular time, that you need some space, you need some time, or you are engaging in activities with your family with the awareness that you need boundaries. Your transformative opportunity is that you are receiving soul guidance and guardianship in order to do this. This is the yin symbol law card. This law card of Jesus is all about receiving that acceptance, that assistance rather, receiving that guidance from your angels, your guides, and your ancestors, from the Christ consciousness, from those in your family, friends that are typically not people that you go to, but they are go-to people for this particular healing process of release, of grieving the mother that you want at this particular time. The yin symbol is also the symbol of Venus. And so Venus being in Libra in the Western astrology at this time is in your 12th house. And so you probably are feeling a little alienated and a little estranged from others at this particular time. But your inner self, your soul self, that part of you that is Libra, does have the support that it needs. Now, let's be clear. The Libra is your sidereal moon sign. Now, Libra in the Western, which is where Venus is right now, is your physical relationships, the Western astrology with individuals. Of course, Venus is in Virgo in the sidereal. What to overlook is, not to overlook, is Pachamama. Pachamama is an energy of the breast, the bosom of Great Mother manifested. Don't overlook the bosom of Great Mother manifested wherever you are. You may be near snowy mountains or hills. You may be near waters, the air, the fairies, the trees. Wherever that variant energy of Great Mother is, whether it's an Earth Mother form or whether it's another archetype of her loving energy, wholesome, good food, give yourself that. Give yourself that at this particular time. It's a root chakra, okay, waning gibbous moon card. Share the goodness of life with yourself at this particular time. It's really important that you do that because in the center of your reading, Scorpio moon sign people, is Adi Shakti. You've done all that you can do at this particular time as it relates to Mama Drama Trauma. You've tried everything that you know how to do. The Adi Shakti card is the scene in The Wizard of Oz of the Twister dream. And that is when Dorothy returns back home when she is afraid to run away. And so you're not at the point where you're ready to completely break away, establish boundaries, and live in loving detachment to give yourself the time and space you need to heal yet. You're not there yet. But because you've done all that you can do at this particular time. And Great Mother is acknowledging that with the second chakra Ankh symbol. This is also a waning gibbous moon card. And so she's saying, give to yourself the time and space that you need. And so maybe even in the midst of the festivities, that you just go outside, gently close the door, and, you know, bundle up and sit on a lawn chair somewhere. And just breathe in the cool air and just take care of yourself just for a moment. Just let the anxiety roll and just keep reminding yourself that my divinity is bigger than all of this. Our divinity is bigger than all of this. We all truly love each other and ourselves and our soul self, but we're learning right now. And I'm learning to love myself. I need this space to give myself love. And just speak that to yourself. Just speak, I need this space to give myself love. I need this space to give myself a... I breathe in love. Exhale toxicity. Give that to yourself. Okay? Because in your shadow position is a need to express yourself. The rebirth card of divine expression is a fifth chakra card. It is about expressing yourself. It's about that breath of life. It is about the rebirth of life through the breath and through your actual physical experience with others that you have incarnated with. And so the soul group that you've incarnated with, you're around. You're around them. You are involved in the festivities. You are involved, but you are wanting to, as the Scorpio moon knows how to retreat, go ahead and retreat into your space. That's what you need to do. Be truthful with yourself. That's what you need to do. You need to allocate time and the time that is best for you to do it, not around some other activity. You're already there. And so that's already the compromise that you need in terms of the time and space to heal. You take the time and do so graciously because you're loving yourself. It's not about denying anyone else. Again, it's what we focus on that has the charge, that has the energy, because you're kind of dancing around some triggers here. And Great Mother wants you to let go of anything that's going to keep you from loving yourself. This is this Isis self-mothering card. This is the full moon card of your spread. It's all about self-mothering to you. You've done all that you can do. This is the phase after the full moon. And so she wants you to, after this full moon, the 22nd, going into the festivities of the Eve and the Christmas and the whatever to New Year's, to know that you've done all that you can do to take care of yourself as well. What's going to facilitate you in doing this is the Shiva Nagig open card. Shiva Nagig being open is about opening your heart to yourself, opening your heart to yourself to give these things to yourself. This is an important part of your process. Opening of the heart chakra is also the breaking of the heart. Now, in the Western astrology, the breaking of the heart is the ego desire. And so that ego desire, again, talking about the Western, is where we find Venus right now. And so those desires, those things that you really want in your life at this particular time, maybe there are some aspirations or some hopes that you had for this family gathering, or some hopes that you had for some new attitudes, new behaviors, new appreciations to come towards you. But you've already, as you've entered this full moon with the acknowledgement of knowing that there are limitations, there are restrictions to that. And that makes sense because Saturn is in Capricorn and who else do we have in Capricorn? Saturn is in Capricorn and... Well, Saturn is restriction. Saturn is limitations. And that is your third house. And so, you know, that ego, you know, so you've acknowledged that some things are not going to be the way that you would hope them to be. And so take care of yourself. Just take care of yourself. Go somewhere and close the door for 20 minutes. Take a nap for an hour. Okay, it's about recharging you right now. Because you are beginning a new journey, Scorpio moon sign people. You're beginning a new journey. You've tried the other way for a long time. You've tried the other way for a really long time. And so have compassion with yourself. Have compassion with yourself. Realize that, you know, and that you even have the gumption and the wherewithal to continue on this journey. It's been very difficult. Kuan Yin, you have all this heart chakra energy. Boy. You know, Kuan Yin is all about, you know, just accepting. This is when Dorothy meets the three along the path and she accepts, you know, the craziness of the scarecrow and the tin man and all rusty and the lion with all of his bravado. It's acceptance of all of those aspects of yourself. You know yourself better than anyone. And you know better than anyone that you need to take care of yourself at this time. So I'm happy to be able to deliver that to you as a confirmation from Great Mother. She gives us clarity, balance, and confirmation, doesn't she? So thank you very much for tuning in for that and sharing the videos. Love to share the videos to give people readings. I love to do that and coaching. So that helps. And for you to subscribe to have these ongoing messages from her. Thank you for your patience. If you are a subscriber, I've been quite busy with my readings and coaching, and so I'm happy to be here to do this with you today. But above all and most of all, remember, Great Mother loves you, and I do too.
I'm a divine child of the Great Mother, Father God. A divine child of the Great Mother, Father God. I'm a divine child of the Great Mother, Father God. A divine child of the Great Mother, Father God.
I am Great Mother, distills my voice of the Holy Spirit, Yin Divine Mother. Cosmic womb, deep space, the moon. Dark matter, the void, the black hole, Hathor, Isis, Diana. Mommy Easter, Kali, Mammy, and Mother Mary. I am your mother. Your terrestrial, celestial, feminine nature. I unconditionally love you. Hello, divine one caught in the net of your creation. You were not doomed to it. I am here to unravel it, remind you, you are loved. Signs and symbols of astrology, chemistry, geology, geometry, numerology, botany, and biology. Don't you remember? Don't you remember? Great Mother speaks to the humble among us. Great Mother speaks to the humble among us. Divine children of the Great Mother, Father God. Divine children of the Great Mother, Father God. Born hard, so don't even start with me. Born hard, so don't even start with me. Know the difference between emotion and intuition. Know the difference between emotion and intuition.
I'm a divine child of the Great Mother, Father God. A divine child of the Great Mother, Father God. I'm a divine child of the Great Mother, Father God. A divine child of the Great Mother, Father God.
I am Great Mother, the stills my voice of the Holy Spirit, Yin Divine Mother. Cosmic womb, deep space, the moon. Dark matter, the void, the black hole, Hathor, Isis, Diana.